Genesis, he's the breath of life. In Exodus, the Passover lamb. In Leviticus, he's our high priest. Numbers, the fire by night. Deuteronomy, he's Moses' voice. In Joshua, he is salvation's choice. Judges, lawgiver. In Ruth, the kinsman redeemer. First and second Samuel, a trusted prophet. In Kings and Chronicles, he's sovereign. In Ezra, a true and faithful scribe. In Nehemiah, he's a rebuilder of broken walls and lives. In Esther, he's Mordecai's courage. In Job, the timeless redeemer. In the Psalms, he is our morning song. In Proverbs, wisdom's cry. Ecclesiastes, the time and the seasons. In the Song of Solomon, he is the lover's dream. He is. In Isaiah, he's the Prince of Peace. Jeremiah, the weeping prophet. Lamentations, the cry for Israel. Ezekiel, he's the call from sin. In Daniel, the stranger in the fire. In Hosea, he is forever faithful. In Job, he is the Spirit's power. In Amos, the arms that carry us. In Obadiah, he's the Lord our Savior. In Jonah, he's the great missionary. In Micah, the promise of peace. In Nahum, he is our strength and our shield. In Habakkuk and Zephaniah, he's pleading for revival. In Haggai, he restores the lost heritage. In Zechariah, our fountain. In Malachi, he is the Son of Righteousness, rising with healing in his wings. He is. In Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, he is God, man, Messiah. In the book of Acts, he is the fire from heaven. In Romans, he's the grace of God. In Corinthians, the power of love. In Galatians, he is freed from the curse of sin. Ephesians, our glorious treasure. Philippians, the servant's heart. In Colossians, he's the Godhead's Trinity. Thessalonians, our coming King. In Timothy, Titus, Philemon, he's our mediator and our faithful pastor. In Hebrews, the everlasting covenant. In James, the one who heals the sick. In 1 and 2 Peter,